a video in which I want to show a 3 timer circuits. This is the best circuit that I made during my experiments with 3 different timer circuits. Made with a TL071 FET field effect transistor op amp. And this is the loudspeaker. And the circuit is extremely simple. Here it is. With the op amp we make an oscillator. The frequency of that oscillator is determined by this capacitor. And the good thing from this field effect transistor op amp is that with very small capacitors, say 1N5, 1500 picofarad, you can get a quite good beep frequency in the audio band, approximately 2000 Hz. Here the pin connections. All these circuits that I want to show are based on a very simple principle, and that principle is here. An electrolytic capacitor is charged with a certain amount of charge, and we use here an NPN transistor, so the charge must be positive to activate that NPN transistor. And here is the crocodile clip with which we can add charge to that capacitor. Of course, I don't do that directly. I use a resistor, and that resistor is here, because otherwise you have a quite high inrush current when you charge that capacitor. So I do that via this 1K resistor. And that's here. Here. So, I've given this circuit a certain amount of charge. The charge came from these 3 batteries, each 0.5 volts. So, totally 4.5 volts. And this circuit is also one of the better circuits because it doesn't take a high current when it is working, when it is beeping, and when the capacitor is activated. So in a kind of say sleep position, where we wait till the moment that this capacitor is completely depleted, it also doesn't take so much current, approximately 2.5 milliampere. And 800 microampere in that during the time when the capacitor is depleted to a certain moment. Here are some times that you can take in account. I have to say the capacitor has to be healthy. When it's not healthy, you can wait for many, say an hour or 1.5 hours, and you will see nothing happen in this circuit. The oscillator will not start to beep because of the, say, too high DC resistance between the 2 electrodes of that electrolytic capacitor. So, you can also use this circuit as a electrolytic capacitor tester. Of course, you need some time when you test such a capacitor. Could take 1 hour or so when it's healthy till the beeper starts to work. I did some tests with bridging this electrolytic capacitor with very high resistors, say in a 10 megaohm up to 30 megaohm range, but that did not have the right effect, so I publish it as it is and do some experiments with healthy and or more healthy and less healthy electrolytics with this circuit anyway. Times are approximately 100 microfarad gives 23 minutes, 1000 microfarad gives approximately 50 minutes. After that moment, the circuit starts to beep. Another circuit that I made in the past, it was tested and the circuit is here. Problem with this circuit was that it took too much current during timing, and when the beeper was affected, was in use, the whole circuit took approximately, say, 7 milliampere, and in my opinion that was not good or not good enough for a battery circuit. These batteries are, of course, have a quite high, say, energy content, but batteries are never ideal. So when you develop a battery circuit, the best thing is to make it in such a way that the electronic circuit takes the lowest current as possible. And for instance, you can see that here, commercial circuit from China. It was a timer for some LEDs, and you can see here a chip and here a crystal. So we have here a real timer with a crystal, and I'm absolutely sure this timer from China did not take so much current when it was timing. You can press the button here, could press the button here. I salvaged that from a Christmas LED unit. Anyway, I think this is an ideal circuit, but of course, as a hobbyist, you can also make circuits that also don't take too much current, like this one. So this one took too much current anyway. You can make it, no problem at all. Another problem from this circuit was that the beeper was not very fierce. So I did not have a too good sound that was audible in the complete living room. And with this beeper, with the TL071 chip op amp, that worked pretty good. Bend over somewhat. Finally, I want to show another circuit that I made with a MOSFET. And my idea was that, for instance, a filter vector resistor has a very high input impedance, and that means that when we discharge a capacitor into the gate of a filter vector resistor, it could be that the time during which that capacitor can dump its charge into the gate of a filter vector resistor is very, very long before that capacitor is depleted. So this was the first experiment, but it didn't work out so properly. I also tested this circuit with small signal FET filter vector resistors, but I'm not sure whether I used the right field effect transistors, small signal field effect transistors, because there are so many types, depletion types, for instance, etc., etc. So this worked. I used this MOSFET, the IRFZ46N, and it worked, but didn't work very good. One problem was that it only wanted to work on 6 volts. That was the minimum supply voltage, and that was not what I needed. I needed a smaller supply voltage, 4.5 volts or even 3 volts. I could not get a circuit working on 3 volts, so I used 4.5 volts. But it works. This circuit also works. And in fact, you can use, in my opinion, more or less any NFET in this circuit. And 100 microfarad meant 3 minutes as the time delay. And here is the principle. Perhaps I didn't tell that. Capacitor is charged. The resistor sends out the charge into the transistor or Darlington or MOSFET. And when it is depleted, the MOSFET or the transistor changes its state between the collector and emitter, or the drain and the source, etc., etc. So, I hope this was more or less clear. Let's look at the circuit, how it was made. Of course, when you make such a circuit, there must be no moisture here inside. Moisture may not enter the circuit. Otherwise, you get a leak current between the two electrodes of the electrolytic capacitor. And that means that the time is not reliable, the time will change, etc., etc. And that's more or less the most important thing and problem with this circuit. And of course, different capacitors can give different results. So it's even possible that 200 microfarad capacitors don't give the same time. That can vary, for instance, 10% or 20%. And you have to, experiment that out.